Since Tizen is based on Linux, like Android, we're quite familiar with getting around our device. But here we will focus on formalizing what we know and add on to it. Hi, Vincent here again, your guide in providing a better user experience in your Tizen applications. After settling with how the information is organized in your application, next thing to consider are the orientations it would support. The default orientation is portrait, but you could also use landscape and reverse landscape. Though it is made available, reverse landscape is not recommended. A few points for going landscape. Mind the adjustments of controls due to relativity. Consider the app results, whether the orientation is a factor. And lastly, app functionalities, simplicity, and complexity, like the calculator app, as an example. How the user navigates through the app is the heart of its usability. As a developer, we should make it a point to enhance the application's user experience. We have the physical keys. Menu shows the options and additional actions. Home takes us to the home screen. Hold it and it shows the list of recent apps. And back, that hide the virtual keypad or notification pop-ups and brings you back to the previous screen of an application. Navigating within your application can involve screen transitions, tabs, or drawers. By using tabs, screens change rapidly. Just choose the tab or swipe inside the tab view to move around, and the back button closes the whole view. The drawer, on the other hand, is accessed by tapping the drawer icon in the top left corner on the main screen, or by swiping from across the edge of the bezel into the screen. From calling one screen to the next comes calling an application on top of the other. This brings the current application to the background and calling another to the foreground. Hitting back, cancel, or done will go back to the previous application. Notifications serve the purpose of calling the user's attention, a call to access your app whether they are active in another or the device is locked. Each notification differs from the purpose of the message, so choose the appropriate one. The first type is an entry in the notification panel. This can be accessed by pulling down from the top bezel. It is a summary and applies to missed events like messages, missed calls, and emails just to keep the user updated. Clicking Clear All dismisses all but the non-removable notifications like ongoing tasks. Next are the badges. This is used for non-urgent information. It simply places a number on the top right side of the application's icon. The exact opposite of being non-urgent is the full view notification. It is time critical that the user must perform action before anything else, but here you will still have the option to dismiss the event. Next, we have the pop-ups of three types. So, depending on what you want the user to do, you can choose from basic information delivery that deactivates on its own after some time, important information delivery, which requires interaction to deactivate, and action or delete choice that asks the user to make a decision. For notifications that are results of actions, we have instant notifications. No more action is required for these because it is just an FYI. This usually occurs through a toast or scrolling text with an icon in the indicator. Edit is probably the most commonly used functions in managing data. It is evident from content creation, location specification, up to data deletion. Without this feature, it would seem like the user's action is limited, ruling out a part of personalization. Speaking of personalization, settings adjustment also plays a vital role. This not only involves the main phone settings, but the settings within the application. Not all users would prefer something different, and this enhances the user experience. In designing application preferences, here are UI control types at your disposal. Secondary texts that show the present state within the list and provide aid to users. On or off switches that allows the user to toggle a specific function. And lastly, the slider that is useful when adjusting values in multiple or consecutive steps. Images and text may be recommended in portraying the meaning of the bar. Maximize a screen without having a cluttered UI. It is easy on the eyes to have everything in its place, all the more if it has everything that you need. And lastly, depending on the information you want to pass on to the user, comes levels of intrusiveness. That's it for Tizen Interactivity. If you have any inquiries, go to register and log on to developer.samsung.com and developer.tizen.org. Also, don't forget to give a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to the Samsung Developers channel. Thanks for watching.